guys, you are welcome to Danemcom TV, where we publish news on politics, entertainment, celebrities and metro stories. We have another trending news for you today, and the headline here is deploying troops to hometown of Mass Nnamdi Kanu few days before his parents' burial is reckless. Alright guys, please, before I go ahead to read today's news to you, if this is your first time you are watching on our channel, please, there is a red subscribe button below this video. Just go ahead, hit that red subscribe button and then click on the bell icon beside it, so as to be the first to be notified whenever we publish news in the future on this channel without you missing any news again. Now the news in details. The outspoken one-time aviation minister, Barrister Fani, Femi, Kayode, lambasted Mr. President in holy anger for deploying troops to the hometown of Mass Nnamdi Kanu few days before his parents' burial. According to him, the deployment of troops to the hometown of Mass Nnamdi Kanu a few days before his parents' burial is reckless and insensitive. Won't he be allowed to bury his parents in peace? Is that too much to ask? Must Buhari pursue his perceived enemies to the grave and the afterlife? This is a question coming from Fani, Femi, Kayode. I think Barrister Fani was right. Mr. President is placing more emphasis on inconsequential issues when the nation is facing greater challenges like Boko Haram, banditry, kidnapping and so on and so forth. The issue of insecurity should be given more attention than arresting harmless Nnamdi Kanu and his followers of IPOB. After all, the Biafrans are threatened to break away because of perceived hatred and collapsed order prevents in the country in recent times. I also agree with Barrister Fani that Mr. President should allow KANU to bury his dead. He has not done any harm to the country. In a democratic setting, people have their way, while the government have their own way. Mass Nnamdi Kanu is only having his way, and he says, in Nigerians' politics as a citizen. Let Mr. President apply the spirit of sportsmanship while dealing with those that he perceives as his political enemies. If Mass Nnamdi Kanu is one of his political enemies, his advisors should know the paving ways and respectful ways to deal with him. Don't forget, the international communities, the European communities are watching. Nigerians are not owned by only a tribe like Fulanis, or like Hausas, or like Guerra's family. Nigerians are owned by all of us, which include even the IPOBs and Mass Nnamdi Kanu. Attacking KANU in such atmosphere will be outrageous. There may be clash between IPOB and Nigerian troops, and people may die, which is not a good record to the government of Mr. Buhari and his APC administration. Such insensitive move may even create a situation that may facilitate the birth of United States of Biafra, USB, as May said. I suggest and advise the President of Nigeria, Mr. Buhari, to think wise and retreat his troops from Afariku Ibeku and allow the young man, Mr. Nnamdi Kanu, to bury his dead in peace. After that, if there is any case or alarms that the government of Nigeria is seeking Mr. Nnamdi Kanu, then thereafter they can go before him or after him. I suggest that Mr. President should take a second thought on his decision, and his advisors should earlyly advise him to avoid this reckless and looming war between Biafra and Nigerian, because the people of Biafra I know and I see today are not that of yesterday of Biafrans. Be warned, and let us listen carefully the wing and what is saying. Feel free to share your thoughts on this pressing issue. It is a very pressing issue that we all have to comment, and let us know what you think, because this is a crucial topic that needs to be shared to all Nigerians. All right, we have a lot of comments here, but we are obligated to read only one or two comments, because there are many pumping over here. Now we have a comment coming from Mado. Mado said, without this misact of the Jubri, how will you clearly understand the true mission of the Boko Harams and their key master planner? So this is showing the world that Boko Harams were being formed and organized by this present administration of Mr. Buhari with all sorts of manners in order to pull all Igbos to the grave, but not knowing fully well that Biafrans are not alone, but someone very special and higher above all other principalities, do goes and walk along with all the true Biafrans. We are unstoppable. God is with us. I'm so happy that Jehovah Lord is always in control in our endeavors. Amen. We are going to get Biafra. Our leader must come to bury his parents. Nothing the zoo, nothing Buhari and his military can do. We are Biafrans and we are ready. Mr. Barrister Fani Kayode, do not worry yourself. We Biafrans are ready. We are ready for whatever Nigerian government and its troop want. See what we are saying? This young man is a core Biafra, is ready, and most of them are ready. So we ask the government of Nigeria to step aside with their troop in the Afaroku Ibeku, the hometown of Mars in Nnamdi Kanu. It will be a disaster, as many are saying it. And there is no how if Mas Nnamdi Kanu can come home to bury his parents that the IPOP members will allow such troop in Afaroku Ibeku. And as the news is saying that the military has blocked the road leading to the palace of His Royal Highness Eze Okukanu, which is a very bad event, and the world are watching. The European Union are watching. The Americans are watching. Please drop your comments and let's see and know what you think. Meanwhile, coming to the end of the news, we urge you to don't forget to drop your comments concerning your opinion over this issue. It is a very pressing one. It is very also important for you to share your own view. Again, do not forget to hit on the red subscribe button below this video. Then click on the bell icon beside it so as to be the first to get notification whenever we publish news on this channel, Dynamicom TV, in future without you missing any news again. Thank you and welcome.